Hi, I'm Cathy with Level Up RN. In this video, I will be talking about nutritional guidance for a number of gastrointestinal disorders, including cholelithiasis, cholecystitis, cirrhosis, and pancreatitis. At the end of the video, I'm going to give you guys a quiz to test your understanding of some of the key points I'll be covering. So definitely stay tuned for that. And if you have our Level Up RN nutrition flashcards, go ahead and pull out your flashcard on these disorders so you can follow along with me. First, let's talk about cholelithiasis, which is a fancy name for gallstones. So most people with gallstones don't have any signs or symptoms. However, gallstones can obstruct the cystic duct, leading to inflammation of the gallbladder, which is cholecystitis. Signs and symptoms of cholecystitis include right upper quadrant abdominal pain, pain after the ingestion of high-fat foods, nausea and vomiting, bloating, and gas. Our cool chicken hint to help you remember the key risk factors associated with gallbladder disease is to remember the four Fs, which include female, fat, over 40, and a family history. In terms of nutritional guidance, individuals with gallbladder disease are advised to consume a low-fat diet, specifically unhealthy fats such as fried foods and greasy foods should be avoided. Experts also recommend increasing fiber intake and avoiding refined carbohydrates. And then individuals should lose weight if applicable and get regular physical exercise. Next, let's talk about cirrhosis, which is a disorder characterized by damage and scarring of the liver. Key causes of cirrhosis include alcoholism, non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, and chronic hepatitis. Cirrhosis can cause a variety of symptoms, such as fatigue, nausea and vomiting, jaundice, ascites, and bleeding, just to name a few. And if you want all the details about cirrhosis, we have a separate video that is just dedicated to this disorder. So definitely check that out. In terms of nutritional guidance for patients with cirrhosis, patients are advised to limit their sodium intake, consume small, frequent meals, take vitamin and mineral supplements as ordered, and abstain from alcohol. Finally, let's talk about pancreatitis, which is inflammation of the pancreas. Common causes of pancreatitis include heavy alcohol use, bile tract disease, and medications. Symptoms of pancreatitis include severe right upper quadrant or epigastric pain, as well as nausea and vomiting. During an acute pancreatitis attack, patients are typically put on NPO, so nothing to eat or drink, and given IV fluids. Ongoing, a low-fat diet is typically recommended, and patients are advised to abstain from alcohol and smoking. And then individuals with chronic pancreatitis may require pancreatic enzymes with their meals and snacks to help assist with digestion. All right, it's quiz time. Are you guys ready? Question number one, is a low-fat diet recommended for cholecystitis, pancreatitis, or both? The answer is both. Question number two, what diet is recommended for a patient experiencing an acute pancreatitis attack? The answer is NPO, so nothing to eat or drink. Question number three, individuals with cirrhosis or pancreatitis are advised to abstain from alcohol. True or false? The answer is true. All right, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful. Thank you so much for watching and good luck with studying. We invite you to subscribe to our channel and share a link with your classmates and friends in nursing school. And if you found value in this video, be sure to hit that like button and let us know what you found to be particularly helpful.